Hi, everyone. It's Ken LaRue from the Shotgun Team, and here's our tip for today in 30 Tips in 30 Days. This is going to focus on how you can create a Canvas page. Canvas pages are really designed for reporting on different things that are part of your project at one time. It's a page you create, and you can customize it to give you the information that you need. It's a very, very helpful and powerful tool. So if I want to create a new page, I'll go to the All Pages flyout on the global navigation bar. I'll choose the gear down on the bottom, you see right here in the left corner, and choose New Page. I'll name it BBB Dashboard. And then for the type, I'll click on the field. You can see I can create any number of pages that are available. But down in the very bottom, actually the second from last, is Canvas. I choose that. Now it's automatically going to be associated with Big Buck Bunny because I'm logged into that project. And I could just name this Ken's Info Page for more description if I wanted to. You don't have to put it in the description, but I'm just adding it. And I choose Create the Page. Now I'm looking at the Big Buck Bunny dashboard canvas page. There's nothing on it yet. It's an empty canvas. That's why it's called the canvas. Let's go into Edit Design Mode. And here we have several different controls along the left-hand side, such as your page. Again, there's the name. You can add tags and folders, share with what project. You can control who is going to see the page. Maybe you don't want your artist seeing this page. Maybe you don't want the manager and so on. If we go to the view, here you can start to control how many rows and columns will be available on the page. You can add more and so on. And then on the widget page, here's different widgets we can start dragging and dropping onto the canvas to create the page that we want to create. So first I'll take the thumbnail widget and I'll drag and drop it. It's now added into my page. I'll add a task and Gantt over here. I'll take a grid and drag and drop it below here so it's underneath my thumbnail widget. And lastly, I'll take a task assign card and drag and drop that there. Now you can continue to drag more widgets if you wanted to, but for demonstration, I'm going to stick with just these four. So let's start to configure and edit these widgets. So for my thumbnail widget, what I really want these thumbnails to be is not of an asset. I want to see the people that I'm working with. Then I can choose configure, and we can come in here, and I can go to filter, and I can say, let's create a new save filter. I'll choose projects from my flyout, includes, and I'll start typing the word current, which will bring up Big Buck Bunny. Now before I click create, let me name this people on project. Then I choose create, and then I'll choose save in the upper right corner. Now this thumbnail widget is showing me all the people that are part of my project. And I've got a little slider. I can control the size of the thumbnails if I wanted to. Let's configure our task in our Gantt widget. I want to see just certain tasks that are happening, such as the lighting and the layout. So I can click configure widget. We'll see all of our tasks and the Gantt display. Let's go to our filter. Like I said, I just want to see the layout and the lighting inside of this widget. And then I just click away and choose save. So now I've got my lighting and my layout available to me inside the task and Gantt widget. Down below for my grid widget, what I want this to be is the assets, but I want to control what assets I'm going to be seeing. So I'm going to choose configure, and then again I can go to my filters and I can choose the in progress and ready to start, and then choose save. Now I've customized what assets I can see inside this widget. And lastly, we have our task assign card widget. Let's configure that. So I choose configure widget. I'll come over to our filters. Assign to includes me, plus I want to see what Gary is working on, and I want to see what the artist Laura is working on. For the status, I want to make sure that my choices is not. And final is for my status. So if I click preview, I'm now going to see all of the work that is assigned to myself, Gary, and Laura. And I'm going to see all the things they're working on that are either in progress, ready to start, or waiting to start. I'll choose save. So now I've customized my canvas page with information I want to get to all the time. So if I choose save, we're now looking at the BBB Big Buck Bunny dashboard page, and I have all this information available to me. And now as I'm working, let's say I'm looking at my shots page, and I want to get back to that canvas page, my dashboard. I go to all pages, I scroll down, there's my BBB dashboard. I choose that, and boom, my Canvas page reloads for me. So as you can see, the Canvas page is a very powerful tool for being able to create custom pages to get the information that you need, especially when you want to access multiple data information in one location. That's our tip for today, 30 tips in 30 days.